I met Etal Adnan in Beirut 15 years ago with Khalil, and I would say, like, very quickly we had this idea to go to Izmir together, because her mother was born there. She was Greek from Izmir, and my grandfather was a Greek from Izmir also, and he had to leave in 1922, and all my life I heard this story about how we lost Smyrna, how we lost everything, and the story how they arrived in Lebanon by boat. And so with Etali, there was always this idea that we would go together one day to Izmir and we would film that, and it would be like a journey.
Et nous, on habitait juste là, enfin nous, ouais. Ils habitaient là, comme ça, ouais. La Tishrefiye, ici.
Ça, c'est les Arméniens.
Et là, c'est tous les bazars.
Et où était le... Ça, c'est le quartier juif. Ouais, et où synagogue. Étaient les Turcs musulmans? Ils étaient là.
Là-bas, ils étaient. C'est de l'autre côté, là, juste là.
Ah non, pas près des Grecs.
Ah là, là, regarde, il est là, le quartier juif. Bon, voilà. Tu as le quartier turc arménien, et les Grecs
c'est
ont...
ça.
We never did that, because now she's not taking any planes, and we delayed this trip for forever, in a way. So, when everything... when it was clear that we would not go together, I thought with Khalil that let's go make and bring her back images. And we've been working on this film for 4 years, because it was really step by step and little by little, you know, recording something in her apartment and taking some sound. It was like that, you know, this those films that you make little by little, and you take your time making them. And when we had this show in Jeu de Paume and Sharjah and Hauser Kunst, and they wanted to commission a work, suddenly it was clear that this would be the good work to do. First, because of the subject, and second, because today, with all what's happening around us, you feel that there is something chaotic, and that you don't really understand how to deal as an artist with all that's happening. And we felt that bringing back ideas of poetry, of re-questioning belongings, re-questioning this idea of cosmopolitanism, of trying to understand what's happening during the Ottoman Empire in that region, and why everything was dismantled, and maybe that we inherit some of it today. We felt it was interesting to really go ahead with the film now. I will also add that, you know, films are made in a special way. You carry them for a long time, and finally it's a moment to do them or to release them, or, you know, it's just like that. And so we've been carrying this film with us for many years, and it takes its form. Suddenly, we accept that it would be this kind of film, film where we, like, I was interested with Khalil with this idea, like, how do you, can you have a film based on kind of very intimate conversation, and finally that could reach others? Can it work, like, you are, like, listening to an intimate conversation, but in the same time, could you, could it be like a window to see something else? The work I've been doing with Khalil, films, installation, photography, everything, we based our reflection on three things especially. We want to understand more how to live in our presence, and we work a lot on construction of imaginaries and writing of history. So of course the past is something that we recall in our work, but we are not centered on the past. What we are interested in is how you can reactivate the past today. What happened, for example, if you do a sculpture of a rocket that was a scientific project, a part of a scientific project in the 60s, and that you reactivated today? What happened today? How is this connection with other temporalities? And in this film, for example, using archives was, of course, very important, but in a way we treated them to be able to understand more what would be our position today with this story coming from the past. You know, we come from a from places where writing of history is very problematic. I think that everywhere writing of history is very problematic, but in some places it is more than the other. And we don't share a history. So for Khalil and me, what was very interesting all the time is to work on what we call the anecdotes. It's this idea of stories kept secret. Those small stories that you never really hear in book history books, but that is a kind of resistance to the official history, the ones that we inherited, and that is in a way wrote by people that has a power. So these are some small stories that we are interested in because we don't think they are small at all. But and so there's this, for example, a space project that is in the 60s in Lebanon, totally forgotten, or a story around internet spams and scams that we've been working on, or for example, this story. So recalling, for example, Etel's personal history or mine was not just a way to talk about our families or our history. It was a way to see how, if you are very specific from something from the past, coming back, something that is not the truth, because it's something that it was transmitted to you, and something that was in a way part of a family imaginary or that you reconstructed, because in the film there's always this part of what is true, what is not true, we don't know, and it's not so important in a way. So it's dealing with this idea of imaginaries and what you do with it today. How we reconstruct ourselves with what our parents or grandparents transmitted to us. How you can, in a way, not always carry this sorrow of your parents, but you can let go, in a way, you can get rid of it. And for us, it's clearly also a message to the way everyone is very attached today to its particularism, his nationalism, his the way everyone thinks that identity is adversity. For us, identity is kind of multi-layers, cultural things that has to be totally hybrid, and this is what is interesting in it, this idea of cosmopolitanism, but in a very specific way. And so, for example, in Je veux voir, we wanted to make this film in a way that it would be not controlled or less controlled as possible. This idea of in situation where there is where you come after a war, after a kind of catastrophe, you cannot make yourself the guy who's filming with a lot of control. You have to be in a very fragile and vulnerable position. And this is something that I really, with Khalil, we really search in our work. So this idea, it's this encounter between Catherine and Rabia was this idea, like maybe nothing would happen between them. Maybe they will go in this car and there was no dialogue, nothing, because of course we don't give them a script, we don't give them anything. They just go, and if there is an encounter, it's better than to film a real encounter. Why do you have to, you know, reset an encounter? So, and with Etel, it was a little bit different, but it was this idea also that we begin talking, we didn't really know where we were going, where we were heading to. And these positions of being able to just you know, see what's going to happen to you and to control without controlling, to try to, for me, this is the encounters deeply and profoundly. When we begin to do Je veux voir, we were in a position where we didn't know what to do anymore. We didn't know how to react with images and or what kind of film we could do after this kind of catastrophe that happened, and where images were very useless in a way, because it was images didn't have any power to stop anything, like we see today with images coming from Syria or other places. We know exactly what's happening. It's not that we're not informed, but So, je veux voir had this question of what do you do with images today? How do you bring back fiction in places where documentary, in a way, has its place? Because everything is so strong, reality is so strong, that what can you do with it? How can you bring people to look at it in a different way, where you think that maybe, you know, they don't see any more ruins and victims because of so many reasons? And in Film Izmirna, and what we have been doing lately, it's the idea like, what could you oppose to the chaos? Not in a good way, because chaos can be positive in a way, but here we see that there is a lot of coming back of a kind of barbarous or chaotic things, and maybe poetry could be a good way to do it, because poetry is a kind of language that could unite others. And so in Izmir, it's the encounter with poetry also.